Good morning. Welcome to the UU Treehouse. I'm Stephen Mead and friends, here to tell another story that we can have fun with and learn something from. Today's story is called When You Have More Than Enough. It was written by one of my colleagues, Dawn Starr, Sarah Borschult. Once upon a time, there was a family. And maybe this family had quite enough to eat, or maybe it just enough. Or perhaps they had more than enough. You might not have been able to tell, and they might not have been able to tell either. Sometimes it's hard to tell if you have enough or not. It's hard not to want more or different things than you have. In any case, the family came together one autumn day for a celebration, a feast, a time of gratitude. And they gathered as we do around a table. There was food, there was drink, and there were flowers to remind them of beauty. And then there was a call from the gate outside their door. Hello, hello, we're hungry and thirsty. And we see you have a feast. May we come in? Well, the family didn't know what to answer at first. Who were these people? Was it safe to let them in? Did they have enough to share, and was there room? But they remembered. They remembered that most of them had come to this family, to this celebration, from someplace else. They remembered that even they who were there at that table had not always been kind to each other. There had been times when they had hurt each other, and there were still times when they made each other sad or angry or afraid. And there's no way to make life completely safe. So they remembered times when others had shared with them, even when the others might not have had enough of their own. And they remembered when each new member of the family had been born or come to stay or married in. They remembered that they had always found a way to make room. And they remembered an old, old saying, when you have more than you need, it is better to build a longer table than build a higher wall. We have enough, they said. We might have more than enough. We are many and strong, and we can hold a safe place in our home for all who come here. And so they went out of their door and to the gate, to the fence, and opened it and invited the people who were there in. And inside, they pulled out another table and made space for these newcomers. And they covered it with a cloth, and the newcomers set a dish of something wonderfully fragrant that they had brought, which was strange and wonderful to the family. And everybody shared. And there was enough. I want us to notice that in this story, we only heard part. We only heard the story of the people who were in the family, in the house, ready to feast. We didn't hear the story of the people at the gate wanting to come in. We don't know who they are or why they were there or what they would bring to the table other than the strange and wonderful food. So, when you hear other stories, I want you to think about whose stories they are and whose stories they aren't, and what those other stories might have been. And remember, when you have more than you need, it is better to build a longer table than a higher wall.